Hello everyone, today we'll be discussing the remaining problems of miscellaneous exercise of chapter number 10, straight lines. The first question which we are dealing is question number 20. If the sum of the perpendicular distances of a variable point P of x comma y from the lines x plus y minus 5 equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0 is always 10, show that P must move on a line. So you have been given a condition that from the point x comma y to this line, what is the perpendicular distance you have to find out? Again, from the same point P of x comma y, perpendicular distance of this line, and their sum should be equal to 10. That condition is given to you. You have to show that if this is the condition, the point P must move on a line. That means you have to get the equation of a line. What is that? You have to get the at last the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Okay, so let's start with the perpendicular distances. The given equations are x plus y minus 5 equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0. Okay. Now we will find out what is the perpendicular distance. Now perpendicular distance of the point that is given to you of P of x comma y from the line, this is 1, this is equation number 2. So from equation number 1 will be what is given as perpendicular distance is equal to mod of ax plus by plus c, that is ax1. Here the point is x comma y, that means you don't have any change in the equation also. That means ax1 will become ax only, that means the same thing, plus y minus 5. So it is ax1 plus by 1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square. The coefficient of x is 1, so 1 square plus 1 square, which is equal to mod of x plus y minus 5 divided by root of 2. Okay, so that is a perpendicular distance of P of x comma y from first equation or from the first line. Now we'll find out the perpendicular distance of P of xy from the second equation. And that will be again the point which is given, x1, y1 is same as x comma y, so that you don't have any change in the equation, which is 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by root of 3 square plus minus 2 the whole square, which is equal to mod of 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by, this is 9, 9 plus 4, you'll get root 13. Okay, now what is given? Their sum, the sum of these two is equal to 10. So you will get it to be given mod of x plus y minus 5 divided by root 2 plus mod of 3x minus 2y plus 7 divided by root 13 is equal to 10. Now after simplification, after taking the LCM, what you will get is, because root 2 and root 13 are always, you are taking it as positive, so that the modulus is not applicable to the denominator. So you will get actually root 13 into, why we are writing, we are just taking it as a term, okay, writing inside the modulus, minus 5 plus, so will give you root 2 into, mod of root 2 into 3x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to, again you will have root 2 into root 13 as the LCM, which will go to the other side as root 26, so it is 10 root 26, okay. Now actually you have four cases. Either both are positive, both are negative. This is positive, this is negative, this is negative, this is positive. So we are just going for one case. Remaining will be automatically followed because only the change will be there in the sign. So if you are able to prove that one case is giving you a equation of a line, then remaining follows. Okay. So we are just taking when x plus y minus 5, this one, is greater than or equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 is also greater than or equal to 0. This is one case. So we are proving for this case and remaining will be followed. So we'll get this equation to be root 13 into x plus y minus 5 plus root 2 into 3x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 10 root 26. So we are just collecting the terms of x together, then y and then constant. So here you'll get root 13x and this is your 3 root 2x. So you can write it as root 13 plus 3 root 2 whole into x. Next term for y will give you here root 13 and here you have minus 2 root 2. So root 13 minus 2 root 2 into y, remaining constants. This is minus 5 root 13 plus 7 root 2 minus 10 root 26 is equal to 0. Now we can just see that this is a constant into x, that is a into x plus b into y. And together these will give you c. So it is in the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, that is representing a line. So we can write this is in the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, which represents a line. Okay, represents a line. Now if you are taking for the other cases, you will get similar things. The only thing is either here it is negative or here it is negative, only positive negative change will be there, but the form will be same as ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Okay, similarly for all cases, for the cases when, first thing is this, that is when x plus y minus 5 is less than 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 is greater than or equal to 0. That is, one is negative, one is positive, and x plus y minus 5 is greater than or equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 is less than 0. And the last case is when both are negative, x plus y minus 5 less than 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 is less than 0. For all these cases, when this occurs, it will be representing a line. Okay. Question number 21 is, find the equation of the line which is equidistant from parallel lines 9x plus 6y minus 7 equal to 0 and 3x plus 2y plus 6 equal to 0. So first we will take any point on the required line and then we will find out the distance, that is the distance from the lines. Now you can see that the two lines are parallel because here if you take 3 outside, you will get 3x plus 2y. That means the coefficient of x and y will be same. Okay, so both the lines are given to be parallel. Now what we are taking, let P of x1, y1 be any point on the required line which is equidistant from the given parallel lines, okay, which is equidistant from the given parallel lines. So now we will find out what is the distance, and since they are equal, what you will get, modulus of, for the first line when you have this point, x and y will be replaced with x1 and y1. So you will get mod 9x1 plus 6y1 minus 7 divided by root of 9 square plus 6 square. And this is given to be equal, which is equidistant means from the point to the parallel lines, the distance is same. So you will have this is equal to, for this equation you will replace your x and y with x1 and y1. So you will get 3x1 plus 2y1 plus 6 divided by root of 3 square plus 2 square. Now what you will get, mod of 9x1 plus 6y1 minus 7 divided by, this will give you how much, 81 plus 36 inside the root is equal to mod 3x1 plus 2y1 plus 6 divided by root of, this is 9 plus 4. Modulus of 9x1 plus 6y1 minus 7 divided by root of 117 is equal to 3x1 plus 2y1 plus 6 divided by root 13. Now this is nothing but 3 root 13, that is root of 9 into 13 will give you this root 117. Now again we are just removing this modulus sign. From both the sides you have modulus sign. In order to solve we have to remove it. So you will have plus and minus, plus or minus in one of the sides. So suppose this will become like, I'm just removing the modulus sign so that this is in denominator 3 root 13. Here I will write plus or minus 3x1 plus 2y1 plus 6 divided by root 13. So now I can cancel this root 13 so that this becomes 9x1 plus 6y1 minus 7 is equal to plus or minus 3 into 3x1 plus 2y1 plus 6, right? Now we will not take both the things. That means if they have both same sign, if I'm taking both to be positive or equated this to positive sign, the coefficients of x and y will be same and it will get cancelled so that you will not get any line. So we are just taking the negative sign, opposite sign. That means if this is positive, this should be negative like that. Okay. So here taking only the opposite sign, you will have 9x1 plus 6y1 minus 7 is equal to minus of, this will become 9x1 plus 6y1 plus 18. You can just see if it was positive, 9x1 will get cancelled, 6y1 and 6y1 will get cancelled. That's why we are avoiding the negative sign, same sign. Okay, avoiding the same sign. So here this is negative, this will come here. Okay, I'll just expand it once more. Minus 9x1 minus 6y1 minus 18 in the right hand side, so that this will come here as 9 plus 9, this will become 18x1 plus 6 plus 6, 12y1 minus 7 plus 18 will give you plus 11 equal to 0. Now you can see that this is in the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, which is representing a line, which represents a line. Okay. Therefore, the required equation of the line is we'll just replace x1, y1 as xy. Okay, this was any point on the line. So the line will be 18x plus 12y plus 11 equal to 0. Now question number 22 is, a ray of light passing through the point 1, 2 reflects on the x-axis at a point A and reflected ray passes through the point 5, 3. Find the coordinate of A. So I have drawn a figure in which you can see this as reflected ray. This is the incident ray. This is a reflected ray. So the point where it is touching the x-axis is taken as A. And since it is touching on the x-axis, the coordinate can be taken as x, 0. Now your purpose is to find out what is the value of x so that you will get the coordinate of A. So first we will start with, and one thing which you know is the angle of incidence will be same as angle of reflection. That concept we are using here in order to get the slope. Okay, so the point 1, 2 is taken as B and 5, 3 is taken as C. So you can write, let BA be the incident ray and AC be the reflected ray. Okay. And since A is touching the x-axis, you will have, let the point A be x, 0. Now again, we are taking the angle of incident and the angle of reflection as theta. Angle of incident be theta. So that will be automatically following that angle of reflection is also theta. Okay. Now what is tan theta for the line AC? Because AC is making an angle of theta we have taken. So for the line AC, what will be tan theta? It is y2 minus, you have 2 points, so it is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. What is y2 here? This is your x1, y1, x2, y2. So, or else the other thing you can take, that is up to you, and you just take it as y2 minus y1. If I am taking 3 minus 0, by the other thing will be 5 minus x, right? So, this is your tan theta, or else this is 3 by 5 minus x. Now, we will find out the slope for the second line, that is BA. Again, we have to get the angle. Since this angle is theta here, with the x-axis, the line is making an angle theta. We have to find out the angle which the line BA makes with the x-axis, which the line BA makes with the x-axis. So, what will be that? See, this is your perpendicular. So, here totally you have 90. That means this will become 90 minus theta. Again, this is theta. Here you will have 90 minus theta. That means the sum of these three will give you this much of angle. Okay, so the angle which the line BA makes with x-axis is theta plus 90 minus theta plus 90 minus theta, which is equal to, you will get it to be 180 minus theta. Now, when you get this, you can just find out the slope for the line BA also. Therefore, for the line BA, you have tan of, what is the angle made by that line with the x-axis? 180 minus theta is equal to, again, you can use the same formula for 1, 2 and x0 as y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 will give you 2 minus 0 by 1 minus x, which is equal to 2 by 1 minus x. So here you have got both to be as tan of something like, and here what is tan of 180 minus theta? It is minus tan theta. Minus tan theta is 2 by 1 minus x. So what will be tan theta? Minus 2 by 1 minus x. Now you can just see the left hand side is equal for both these lines, slopes, tan theta, so you can equate the right hand side. Therefore, just mark it as 1 and 2. From 1 and 2, you will get 3 by 5 minus x is equal to minus 2 by 1 minus x, or 3 into 1 minus x is equal to minus 2 into 5 minus x, which is 3 minus 3x is equal to minus 10 plus 2x, that is 5x, which will go there, is equal to 13, which is giving you x as 13 by 5. Therefore, what is the point A? Therefore, the coordinates of the point A. Are x comma 0 you have taken, so you will write 13 by 5 comma 0. Okay. Question number 23 is, prove that the product of the lengths of the perpendiculars drawn from the points root of a square minus b square comma 0 and minus root of a square minus b square comma 0 to the line x by a cos theta plus y by b sin theta is equal to 1 is b square. You have to prove that it is equal to b square. So what we need to do is, first we have to find out the length of the perpendicular from both the points and then take the product, and you have to get it to be equal to b square. So first let p1 and p2 be just a notation, okay, be the lengths of the perpendiculars drawn from the given points to the given line, given points to the given line. Okay, so first what you will get as P1, and you have to remember that this should be made as AX plus BY plus C equal to 0. That means cos theta by a will act as, I'll just write the equation. It is cos x by a cos theta. So I can write it as cos theta by a x. So that this is your a, capital A acting as a x. Okay. Then the other thing is sin theta by b into y. So it is acting as b, capital B. So a x plus b y. And this is equal to 1. We will make it as minus 1 equal to 0. Okay. The given equation is, given equation of the line is, okay. So given line is written in this form. Now it is easy to put the values for the length of the perpendicular. So what is the length taken as for the first? That is P1 is the length of the perpendicular drawn from the given points, means respectively you are taking from the given points respectively to the given line. Okay. Respectively means what? P1 is this, from this point to the line. So that you will get, what is the formula? Mod of ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square. So here this will be acting as x1, y1, and this is your capital A and b, c. Okay, here a will be cos theta by a, b is sin theta by b, and c is minus 1, right? So you'll get p1 as mod of ax1, a will be cos theta by a, into x1 is root of a square minus b square, plus b, that is sin theta by b, into this is your y1 which is 0, plus c is 1, divided by root of a square plus b square. So you'll get cos theta by a the whole square plus sin theta by b the whole square. Okay. Now simplifying this, you will get cos theta by a root of a square minus b square. This will go, it is into 0. So minus 1 divided by root of, here it is cos square theta by a square plus sin square theta by b square. Again inside the modulus. So that is your P1. Now we'll go for what is P2. P2 is equal to, again it is from this point to the line. So you'll get, what is the, a and b are not changing, only the point is changing. For the x1 it is negative, for y1 it is 0 itself. So you'll get cos theta by a, same thing, into here you'll replace this. So you'll have negative of a square minus b square as x1 plus sin theta by b into 0 minus 1 divided by root of, denominator is also same, cos theta by a the whole square plus sin theta by b the whole square, which is equal to mod of, here you will get negative cos theta by a root of a square minus b square minus 1 divided by root of, again cos square theta by a square, plus sin square theta by b square. Now you have to take the product of these two, the product of the lengths of the perpendicular. Therefore, P1, P2 is equal to, get mod of cos theta by a root of a square minus b square minus 1 divided by root of cos square theta by a square plus sin square theta by b square into mod of minus cos theta by a root of a square minus b square minus 1 divided by root of cos square theta by a square plus sin square theta by b square. Right? Now what we are doing is, since here you have both to be root of and root of, it will remove its root and you will get the term as cos square theta by a square plus sin square theta by b square in the denominator. Okay. Root A into root A is A, like that. And here, inside the modulus you have, and here you have both to be negative. So I'm just taking out that negative, and since it is inside the modulus, I can remove that negative sign also. So that this will become as cos theta by A into root of A square minus B square minus 1. Okay, this is your first thing. Divided by, I will write commonly, into mod of, this is taken, that is negative sign is taken out from these two terms, and since it is inside the modulus, it will become positive. So I am writing like cos theta by a root of a square minus b square plus 1. So this has been become positive, this has been, because you have a positive negative in common, that's why I have taken it out. Okay, and the denominator term will become root of this into root of this, same quantity, so that root will be removed and you are getting cos square theta by a square plus sin square theta by b square. Okay, now again this is in the form a plus b into a minus b. This is a minus b, a plus b. So a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. That means you will get here to be mod of cos square theta by a square, root of will be removed, a square minus b square, because this is your total, the whole square, this term the whole square will give you like this, minus 1 square, 1 square is again 1, and divided by is again same. You can just take the LCM there, so it will be b square cos square theta plus a square sin square theta. Now what we are doing is changing this sin square as, here you have cos theta, so I am just changing this sin square in terms of cos, that is 1 minus cos square as your sin square. Okay, so you will have here as again cos square theta into a square minus b square, taking here also LCM, denominator here it is a square b square, and this will give you LCM. After that, the numerator has here a square term, denominator again has a square term, modulus, and here I'm just making it as into, so that this will come up, this will be in the denominator. Okay, I'm just writing for the ease of the calculation, a square b square in the numerator, and this will come as b square cos square theta plus a square into, changing sin square as 1 minus cos square, so you'll have 1 minus cos square theta. Now a square can be cancelled here, and this will give you again mod of cos square theta into a square minus b square minus a square, here you have a b square, just write it here, divided by, this will give you after expansion as b square cos square theta plus a square minus a square cos square theta. Okay, so here now if I'm taking, see, if I'm taking a negative sign from this inside term, it will be b square into modulus of negative sign, but it has a modulus, right? So that will be removed. I'm just taking out means I'm just making it as like this. It will be a square minus cos square theta into a square minus b square, right? So I've just taken negative out. And the denominator, here I'm just writing this first term, a square, positive a square. Then from these two terms, I'm taking a negative sign. So that it will become minus of a square minus b square, because a square was negative and b square was positive. Now a square will be positive and b square will be negative, and the common thing is cos square theta. Now why I am doing like this? In order to make these two terms same. Now you can just see that if it is inside the modulus, I can take it out as a positive quantity, so that this will become b square into, what will that be, a square minus cos square theta into a square minus b square. Denominator is also same, a square minus of cos square theta into a square minus b square. So that these two will get cancelled and you will get it to be b square. Okay, cancelled. Question number 24 is, a person standing at the junction, that is crossing, of two straight paths represented by the equations 2x minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0 and 3x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0 wants to reach the path whose equation is 6x minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0 in the least time. Find the equation of the path that he should follow. So I have drawn a figure in which you can see two lines, that is 2x plus minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0 and 3x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0 as this one and this one, so that you get a junction for this one. Let A be that junction which we are saying, and from this junction the person has to move to the line 6x minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0. So this is that line. So from this point, the person has to go. He has to reach this path or this line in the shortest time, the least time. And we know that the shortest time will be given by the shortest distance. And every time shortest distance is the perpendicular distance. Okay. So what we have to find out? This perpendicular lines equation. Okay. This lines equation A. Suppose this is B. So the equation of the line AB we have to find out. For that, what we are doing is, first we will solve these two equations. That means you will find out that junction, that is the point of intersection of these two lines A, you will find out. And then you will get, see here the equation is given, means since these two are perpendicular, you can get the slope of this line also, which will be the negative reciprocal of this line's slope. So now you will be having with one thing, that is the point through which the line is passing and the slope of this line. And you can use your point slope form to get the equation of the line. Okay. So first we will solve the two given equations, this one and this one. For solving 2x minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0 and 3x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0 will give the junction. Okay. Will give the junction or crossing, that is the point of intersection of the two lines. Okay. So first we will solve. This is 2x minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, or you can say equal to minus 4, and this is 3x plus 4y equal to 5. Now making the coefficients equal, I'm just multiplying this with 3 and this with 2 will give you 6x minus 9y is equal to minus 12, and this will give you 6x plus 8y is equal to 10. Subtracting the two equations will give you minus 9y minus 8y will give you minus 17y equal to minus 12 minus 10 minus 22. So that you are getting y as 22 by 17. Now you have to find out what is x equal to. Put in any of the equations. So suppose this is your equation number 1 and 2. So equation number 1 will give you 2x is equal to, this is having minus 4 plus 3y. Okay, minus 4 plus 3 into 22 by 17 will give you minus 4 into 17 is minus 68, plus this will give you 66 by 17, which is minus 2 by 17. So that is your 2x equal to. So what is x equal to? It will be minus 1 by 17. Therefore, the point of intersection, or you can say the junction, is intersection, that is junction, is minus 1 by 17 comma 22 by 17. Now what we have to do, we have to find out the slope of the required line. Okay, the given line is this one. The slope of 6x minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0 is, what you will get, how will you find out? This is 7y is equal to 6x plus 8, or y is equal to 6 by 7x plus 8 by 7. So this is the slope of the line. The slope of the line is given to be, suppose m1 is equal to 6 by 7. And since these two lines should be perpendicular, why? Because the shortest distance is taken to be the perpendicular distance. Okay. So the slope of the line perpendicular to 6x minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0 is equal to negative reciprocal, that is minus 7 by 6 you will get. Okay, now what will be the equation of the line? Therefore, the equation of the line, required line, will be line, or you can say the path which the person has to follow. Equation of the path of the line which the person has to follow will be y minus y naught. This is acting as your x naught, y naught. So y minus y naught is y minus 22 by 17 is equal to m sloping to minus 7 by 6 into x minus x naught. This will give you plus 1 by 17. Okay, simplifying what you will get. 17y minus 22 is equal to, here again 6 will come here. So this is into 6 also. 6 into this much is equal to minus 7 into 17x plus 1. Okay, that means you will get 6 into 17 will give you 102y minus, here it is 132, is equal to 17 into 7 will give you minus 119x minus 7. Okay, so that the equation becomes, this is here coming. So see, that 17 has been cancelled after taking the LCM. Okay, in the denominator 17 has been cancelled and 6 has come here. Clear? So the equation will be 119x plus 102y minus 132 plus 7 will give you minus 125 equal to 0. So this is your equation of the line, ax plus by plus c equal to 0 form. Okay.